the active hang today. So if you missed our last video, passive hanging is the starting point for most people, except for those with shoulder hypermobility issues. So any previous dislocation or shoulder injury, some people might have to avoid the passive hanging variation. But assuming you don't fall into that category and you've got 60 seconds on the passive hang, we're gonna jump to the active hang next, and Lindsay's gonna help to demonstrate it. Before you jump up, we'll show you guys first, then we'll talk through some of it. So for this one, start the passive hang where we were last time, letting those shoulders shrug up. And then, so see how her shoulders shrug up, and then she's gonna pull just her shoulder blades down and hold for 10 seconds. And notice how her arms don't bend, she's keeping arms straight, all the movement's coming from shoulder blades here, and then go back to the passive hang. And then back to active. So see how she does a really nice job just pulling those shoulder blades back, and less so back, but more so straight down towards her hips. Good, let's try one more. Take a rest, jump off. So she'll start in the passive hang, shoulders shrug up, and then she's gonna pull up, shoulder blades work away from the ears, holding for 10. Good, and then she can jump all the way off there. So she does a great job with that. You'll notice a lot of people, as your arms overhead, it's gonna be hard to coordinate where that shoulder blade is, getting that shoulder blade back. A lot of people wanna bend the elbow as they start to pull, and they're trying to pull with their arms instead of with their shoulder blades. So this is training not only the strength in that position, but getting some more motor control or just pretty much coordination of shoulder blades in that position. So this will build up strength, getting you ready to do the pull-up. So a lot of people will try and pull from the passive position. The last video we did, we'll pull from that passive hanging position, which can put the shoulder in a stress position. But by building up this base of the active position with the shoulder blades first, you're creating a nice healthy position to pull the shoulder off of. So we demonstrated 10 second holds in this one. That's a good starting plate for most people, but eventually you want to be able to work up to, like our passive hang, a full 60 seconds of holding in that active position, which will seem like a lot at first, but you'll notice the more you get to these hanging drills, work them into your warm up, do them before you're doing pull-ups, you'll notice strength will build up pretty quickly in these positions. So try it out first, 10 second holds, working up to a full 60 second hold. And this is something you should be doing most days, especially before any type of pulling workouts. Try this variation out. I'm gonna show you guys the next variation in our pull-up series coming up in the next video. So try it out. Let us know if you guys have any questions.